Display pilot, look out to your right. Here's Vader to start the Belgian F-16 solo display. Between 1979 and 1991, initially as a replacement to the compared with the legacy types, but were initially only equipped with a pulse radar, sidewinder, and guns. Vader going through a very challenging 8-point hesitation roll. Yes, that midlife upgrade took place during the 1980s. Anything up to 40 years old in terms of when they were built. Somewhere in the region of 600 or so knots on that fast pass, not as quick as he would go at some mainland European displays because the maximum speed allowed in the UK. Thank you.
Good morning, Ian. The weather is much better than yesterday. I'm a little happy to see them fly and follow this cloud.
Product itself, of course, the F-16, having been a General Dynamics one when the Belgian examples were built. In over the threshold then, as the two D-Day F-16s come in above for the break to land. D-Day F-16s coming in to land the 350 Squadron aircraft in the hands of a US Air Force Exchange pilot, Major Sean Keemer, call sign Cash, and his colleagues from 349 Squadron in the RAF. Four-ship formation as part of our NATO 70th anniversary flight path here at the Royal International Air Tattoo. Thank you.